next question then, I guess we'll start with Mr. Gutschall, we're going to move on, Mr. Fallon, who wants to answer. So this next question is about corporate welfare. Do you support tax breaks for Nestle, which the question writer suggests is one of the worst corporations in the world?
I will confess that I was not aware, I didn't know that much about Nestle, and I am kind of shocked to hear what's come out since their announcement that they're coming to Arlington. And I don't know whether or not that was a factor in any of the evaluation criteria. I suspect not, and it's probably something that we should investigate a little bit to be sure of. But what I would say about the idea of the tax incentive is I would much rather, while I respect very much, and I think that if you set aside their corporate grievances, the fact that we are getting a major international corporation to come here to Arlington, this is good for Arlington, it's good for filling our office space. But I would rather have seen some of that money go towards, for example, supporting more childcare in either Roslyn or Crystal City. What's going to matter more to those employees? Is it a subsidy that goes straight to the bottom line of the corporation? Or would more accessible childcare be a bigger boon and help attract the next company to Arlington?
So I was fortunate enough this morning to spend 2 hours with the Chamber of Commerce learning about how we recruited Nestle. And we were in competition with Atlanta. And I will say that the Commonwealth, Virginia, did give Nestle a lot of incentives to come here to Arlington. Arlington also gave some incentives. We moved 2 bus stops. We moved a bus covering, and we did a few other things to bring Nestle here. And the reason we brought them is because we had significant vacancies in Roslyn. So you're kind of at a tipping point. You're out of balance. What do? We do need to fill this office space, but what I would like to see that the lessons that we learned from Nestle and the incentives we gave Nestle, we stood up a website for their employees in 3 weeks. If we can stand up a website for Nestle employees in 3 weeks, imagine what we can do for small businesses in 3 weeks. Let's use the lessons we've learned from Nestle and apply them to our medium and to our small businesses.
So this comes to the conversation I've talked about with diversification of our economy. So I serve on the Economic Development Commission. There was a presentation done about Nestle and how it was recruited. A lot of the incentives are performance-based incentives. That means that if Nestle meets certain benchmarks when it comes to employment and fulfilling certain obligations, they get these incentives. So it's not a blanket check to Nestle up front. What I also learned through those presentations was that Nestle is filling about 0.5% of our commercial office vacancy. If you do the math, that's about $1.7 million in property tax revenue every year. I believe that the total incentives to Nestle, I think, are worth about $6 million, so that money pays it back. But I do agree that this is about diversification, which means while we roll out the red carpet for Nestle, we should use such programs to fund entrepreneurs that want to start companies. Imagine you bring an entrepreneur like Elon Musk here, right? And our new entrepreneurs that start companies. You can fill an office-based building with just a new startup company like Opower did, or like Blue Vector and some other cyber companies that have been built here. So that red carpet should be rolled out for small businesses and entrepreneurs, but it has to be a mix and match of incentives across the board.
When I first heard about it, my immediate reaction was, oh, this is the company that is pumping water out of, at the time, drought-stricken California, and did, basically encouraged women in Africa to not breastfeed, but rather to use formula, and because of poverty, it had to water it down. So it was really contributing to childhood malnutrition. Well, that was a number of years ago in some cases, and I like to think that Nestle hopefully has become more enlightened and a better corporate citizen. I do recognize that, though, the economic competitiveness that we are finding regionally and nationally means that incentives, financial incentives to attract business, are pretty much more the norm. One concern that I have is that most of the package was state money. And if we don't have a Democrat in the governor's mansion 4 more years, then we'll, as taxpayers, we in Arlington will have to provide more local money to attract the same businesses. I mean, it's a certain degree of, like, they're just sort of, you know, used car shopping, I think, in some cases. Now, as Vivek pointed out, there were performance benchmarks with the Nestle deal. So overall, I think that probably has worked out all right. But at the end of the day, we have to consider as to who is worthy of the subsidy and what do we get out of it. the end of the day, part of the reason for the 2 cent tax increase is because we're giving millions to Nestle, millions that we don't have available for human services here in Arlington or for the schools.
All right.